question is, how did we even come up with MotoGP? It was never a plan. You know, of course, eventually one day, 5 years later or 10 years later, the ambition is to have a MotoGP team, but not so soon. We were at the right place at the right time. We heard of the situation in the paddock about a MotoGP team, and I just went for it. I gave Carmelo a call to discuss whether this is possible. Immediately, I went and see him in his office. This was in Jerez last year.
And then for that time, we start to work together. Then we see each other in the other Grand Prix after Jerez, in Le Mans, in Mugello, in many Grand Prix. And then the thing has starting to be almost clear. Then we see what was the possibility to do it. Then was the situation where one team was leaving. And then we put all the pieces in place, and finally we do it.
And things got moving very, very fast. And the rest is history.
So 9 nationalities, 11 teams, 6 manufacturers and 419 victories across the 22 riders. Lining up for the first time are 4 rookies, including Quartararo. 22 riders for 2019. Which one stands tallest of all after 19 races?
What I expect from the team is you are carrying one of the biggest brands in motorsports. Everybody knows Petronas in the world of motorsports. You don't have to go far from MotoGP. You look at what they've done in Formula One. Okay, so everybody knows how involved Petronas is in motorsport, the value and the brand it carries. And now Petronas wants to bring it big in MotoGP.
Everybody was very positive from the beginning. And even, you know, I will say the riders, Frankie and Fabio, never hesitated. And I give them big credit for this because it was a new project. We started with a blank sheet of paper and we created this team from that, you know. We bought every single thing ourselves. We didn't take over anything from someone else. We created this team from scratch, which is remarkable in, let's say, 8 months. Can't imagine, don't hesitate, rub the lamp a lad.
That is. I talked with both boys and I said, okay, Fabio, if you want to be Rookie of the Year, you need to have 50, between 50 and 100 points, or 90 points, we said. For Franco, I said, okay, the estimation is a bit higher because we want a best independent rider with you. You need to battle with Carl Critchlow, with Jack Miller. So, you know, I estimate him between 100 and 150 points.
I mean, we have the team, you know. In the end of the day, my target and Wilco and Vasily is to make the best structure we can and keep the guys happy. But in the end of the day, it's the riders who do the job, you know.
My feelings in the first test was, of course, so pleased to be in the team on the bike, but I was not controlling the bike. The bike was controlling me, and I really couldn't ride like a Moto2. Until the first GP, I didn't feel the M1, my bike.
When I jumped on it, I was I went immediately fighting for top six in the first day of test. So I immediately understood the potential of the bike that was really good.
Who will start the first Grand Prix of 2019 from pole position?
Fabio Quartararo on his MotoGP debut. No wonder there are people with big smiles on their faces down that Petronas SRT team, with Quartararo fifth to kick off his MotoGP career.
The fifth position for Fabio in qualifying was the first amazing thing that he has done. Okay, we were on a high when he qualified fifth. We never expected Fabio to be fifth.
The MotoGP World Championship is getting underway. Who will conquer? Who dominates Qatar? We get closer to lights out. What might be?
But of course, the race also brought us back down because he made his first rookie mistake by stalling on the bike.
Oh, there's problems in the background here. I'll stop. Fabio Quartararo cannot get his bike going.
He's got to come off the grid. You have
and
to come off the grid.
This is a nightmare rookie start. What a disaster for Fabio Quartararo, the youngest rider on the grid.
I never do it again this year, apart of Qatar, but this kind of mistake can happen to everybody. You are there and you can do nothing. So that's a shame. It's true that from mistake we learn. That's what they say. And this is good for the next year, trying to don't repeat the mistakes.
Crestfallen Quartararo. We haven't even had the first red lights go out of the season. What a cruel blow.
He did not get into the points, but he did the fastest lap, I think. We went away with a good feeling and a good projection of what he's going to do in the year.
When we arrived in Jerez, actually, it was not a big surprise. Okay, a pole position from a rookie is always a surprise, but let's say the first row was our target.
Is he going on the front row of the grid? He's gone! Pole! Oh! Awesome by Fabio Quartararo! What a lap by Quartararo, 36.880!
The first practice I finished first was on qualifying. So was pole position, really, really great to make the first pole position in Jerez, because my first one ever in Moto3 was there also. So it's a track that I really like and always been fast there.
Let's see if Morbidelli can do it. Will it be a 1-2 for Petronas SRT? Across the line it is!
second for Morbidelli. They can't believe it. They are in dreamland. They cannot believe it.
Times that we both were on par fermé, I guess it was a really nice time for the team, is to have both riders young and in the par fermé with a satellite team and doing such good results.
In our first European round, fourth race of the year, first year, one and two. It's amazing. It's amazing. Everybody was shocked. I mean, we were shocked. Our sponsors were shocked, and they were there.
Fabio Quartararo, he is the youngest ever pole man in MotoGP.
All the Petronas team, and especially the two riders, Quartararo and Franco and Morbidelli, did a fantastic job. They ride very well. In all this weekend, they are fast. So I'm very happy for them. I make my congratulations.
Well, to make a position in MotoGP is always very, very difficult. I mean, for my mentality, is harder than to make a good result in the race. I'm happy for him. I'm happy for Morbidelli. And we can fight tomorrow during the race.
Well, fantastic. You know, I think it's what MotoGP needs. It's not what I needed, obviously. But I mean, I like Fabio. He's a good kid. And congratulations to him and Franco. They did a great job and did a great job as a team.
The youngest ever Premier Class pole in history and the fastest ever lap of Jerez. A 136.880 for Fabio Quartararo. Fabio Quartararo, can he make history again today? 75,000 fans packed into this Jerez circuit. Lights out in Spain!
Moments you always need to take the small positive that you have, even if it's only 1% of positive and 99% of negative. We let the negative and we took only the positive.
The gearbox is jammed. Can you believe it?
They say what doesn't hurt you makes you come back stronger. Well, that is going to take a bit of time for him to get over that one. Devastating for him, gutted for the team.
We win together and we lose together. You know, one part of the bike broke down in Jerez. It's all in the game. And for sure, for 10 minutes, they were frustrated, you know, and crying or whatever, you know. But after 10 minutes, they say, okay, let's continue and forget about it, you know, because we are on our way and nobody can stop us, you know, and this is important.